And this is, I promise, going to be the most complicated part of this unit. Once you've understood this, you have understood how to prove the Cook-Levin theorem, so bear with me for another minute here. If we write this huge Boolean formula, what I would like to ask you now is what properties this Boolean formula has. So if I write a big Boolean formula like this here, so ensuring that exactly one variable here is set to true, one here, and so on and so on. What I would like you to think about is some of the properties that this Boolean formula will have. So there's three properties or three choices that I'm giving you. One is that the size of this Boolean formula here is polynomial in n. The second one is that this Boolean formula here has only a single satisfying assignment. And the third one is that every satisfying assignment of this Boolean formula presents a potential snapshot. So it kind of uniquely defines what the memory of the RAM looks like and where the program is at. Now, of course, there's only three choices here. Again, more than one can be true, and you could make your way through by guessing. But before that, I'd encourage you to think through these statements, because once you understand this part, the rest of the Cook-Levin theorem is actually quite easy.